we're going to play the song, and then we're going to look at the lyrics here. Hazuki is the name of the song. Hazuki. Now, I'm going to use DeepL to translate the lyrics, and you can tell I've done a little bit of it, okay? We're going to listen to it and go through it and see what does it mean. What's going on here in this song? Just looking at the lyrics here, going to blow it up. Yo, give and take, fake, days, oh, Nippon, okay. Okay, let's take that. And let's listen to the song and think about what it could possibly mean and translate the lyrics and give some thoughts about it. Here we go. Damn, that was only 3 minutes, 3 minutes and 36 seconds. It seemed a lot longer. There's so much going on in that song. Really fun, really good, explosive energy. It's explosive energy. Okay, we're going to play the song in bits and translate each part. But overall, the way I would describe it is very tight, especially the riff, very cutting, aggressive, this explosive energy. if I didn't know any better, especially with the kind of rap rock breakdown, we're going to get a lot of attitude in the song. We're going to get a lot of almost like a, I don't know if like a call of rebellion. I don't know. It's just, we're going to find some, it's going to be aggressive. That's all I'm going to say. It's going to be aggressive. We'll see. Really good stuff. All right. We have how it opens up. And I love the drum machine sound of the beat in the beginning. I love that. It kind of reminds me of what is that band? Is it? Ah, shit. Well, Static X comes to mind, but that's not like KMFDM stuff, like that stuff. Or Fate No More? That one, you don't have to translate. She says it's going to blow it up. Okay. So she's already on FBI watch list. Or whatever the equivalent is over there in Japan. Okay, so what does she say there? Well, let's find out. I think it might be this right here. Go ahead and copy this. Rampage. It just translates to rampage. Rampage. Seems so. All right. Now the up part, I don't know about because these characters don't look all the same, but I think there's some variants here that we're just not getting. Alrighty. Well, what else happens? Okay, what about that part? Let me see. I think it's this. I believe so, anyway. Let's find out. Let's see. I don't think so. I think this might be the chorus here. What we just translated. Let's find out. Okay, what are the choruses? It has that oh in the background. Let's see if we can get that. It might be. I think that's this. I really do think that it is this right here. I think this part is the chorus here. Because if I translate this, I'm sure it's gonna like these characters look about the same. This is gonna be like the rampage stuff again. Gimme, you're not here. Praise and adore the true self, adore, praise, pity, your inferiority. Wow, okay. Okay. That's kind of cool. Wait. Praise your pity. praise your pity and inferiority. Your inferiority. I don't know about praising that. Praise your pity. Okay. This right here is the chorus. Bodies bloom and fall and dance in the wind. The days repeat themselves and I can't let go. The hand is ripped open and the blood is dancing in the air. Revolution, redeeming heart, now break it down. Rise above it. Shura, supporting my own life. What does it mean? What's going on here? Well, if you combine it with a rampage. I mean, to me, on the surface, it seems like obvious that it's, like I said, aggressive, calling for some sort of a fight. Bodies bloom and fall and dance in the wind. The days are bodies bloom and fall, dance in the wind. That's some sort of like war. I mean, it could be like literal bodies, human bodies. Are we talking about like flowers? What are we talking about? Is it bodies? I'm thinking human bodies, obviously. The days repeat themselves, and I can't go. I can't let go. The days repeat themselves, and I can't let go. I guess a feeling that she wants to let go, because of how mundane it is, how the monotonous the days are repeating themselves, but she can't let go. Or maybe she can't let go, or she can't escape these days that are just repeating themselves. Like she's trapped in some sort of a like Groundhog Day situation. But the hand is ripped open and the blood is dancing in the air revolution. Going with the previous translation, this could be a war within oneself, a fight within oneself. That could be what's happening here. Not like a societal, like, oh, we're going to rampage, but the feeling of within that you are rampaging within. Could be redeeming heart. Now break it down. Rise above it. Shura, supporting my own life. I don't know what that means. Shura, supporting my own life. Let's listen to this some more. This would be the gimme stuff. That would be the you are not here. You are not here. You're not here to help me. You're not here for me. I'm fighting this war within myself. I'm fighting this for me, or whatever she's going through, whatever's happening here. You're not here. You're not part of it. You should be here, but you're not. That's what I'm getting. Now, this is the rap rock part. That would be this. Well, that would be this right here. Yo, give and take, fake. It's easy to spot this one because there's some English there. And also because just the style and the way it's. Yo, all under pressure after all this time. Give and take, Kazuna fake. Kazuna, I looked it up. Obviously, I wouldn't know what Kazuna was. I'm not going to pretend to be, ooh, I'm so intellectual. I know what Kazuna is. I looked it up. Kazuna, what is, like, connections with other, like, I guess the feeling you share with others, camaraderie, is it right? So fake, give and take, connections, fake. Someday you will perish, useless days. The times have always been innovation. Now is the time to change. Kurori, my Nippon. My Nippon, my son Kur, but I'm not sure what Kurori is. I'm not sure what that is. It's a brand of crunchy sticks. So wait a second. By PepsiCo. Could this song really be just about her having the munchies? Maybe she feels all this way because she's just really hungry and she wants to eat some chips. I don't think that's true. Kurori is a brand of corn puffs. This is not becoming better. The more I look into this, the more it seems that maybe Nemophila singing the song, they're singing about how they're hungry and they're hangry and they're just, that now is the time to change. Kurori are crunchy sticks. My son, like, so her life, she needs that. She needs those snacks. I know it sounds goofy, but I mean, what else is it? You're not here. You're not there for her to give her the snacks, okay? Now, the thing about the bloody hand, that sounds pretty metal. How do you connect that with the word of revolution, which comes up again. How do you connect that to being hangry? Well, there's something about a correlation of revolutions happening when people are without food. I don't know. I mean, maybe if you go without food for a while, you're gonna get angry. You're gonna start wanting to fight. I don't know, man. Look at the ground. Looking at the ground is boring. Raise your face and stand up to the sky. Okay. You got the motivation that's rising in you. Let's create the soul revolution. Call to violence for chips? I think so. What? That's what I want to go with here. The song is about Nemophila being just really hungry. Just really hungry. Just feed him some chips, okay? They'll be happy. Wait, maybe the way she's singing this, maybe she's not happy with the fact that Kurori is her son and her whole existence, her purpose in life. And she wants something more in life. And combine that with looking at the ground as boring. It's time to raise your face and stand up in the sky and be like, you know what? My life is more than just snacks. I need to do more. I need a revolt. Really? Okay. I think you're going to be hungry afterwards. I don't know. What do you think this is about? Oh. Wrong button. Where were we? Go! You say Revolution, you can hear them. Got her solo. I love the attitude. I love the aggression, the energy in the song. The song is so cool. I love the song. It's a really good song. Now we translated the lyrics here using DeepL, obviously, of course. Once against the course, bodies bloom, fall and dance in the wind. The days repeat themselves. I can't let go. So you combine this with that staring at the ground is boring, and that there's a part that's glorifying a bag of chips as being the sun. I kind of compare that to like when, let's say like System of a Down would just say it like eating seeds is a pastime activity. Really just talking about, seeing about how, expressing how these mundane, like little things that mean nothing, mean everything. And it seems to all what life is about when, is there more? Like, what else could happen? Like, do we need a revolt? I mean, I laugh because, I mean, is that a reason to revolt? Because you don't like the snacks and things are boring? I mean, I guess. Things will get very exciting if a revolution were to kick off. Oh, yeah. It could get really exciting, but probably not the way you want. Oh, yeah, and if the revolution is successful, well, things will get really, really, really exciting, but probably not the way you want. Treachery and inhumanity. I still go that there's a sense of humor in the song. Maybe. Maybe it's not serious. Maybe it really is that they're hangry and they have this nagging desire for this bag of chips. And they're wanting to revolt because they just don't have it. The days are repeating themselves. All she can do is think about it. Okay. This line here, Monogatari, that is a little bit like a cousin. I don't really know what that. Not sure what that means. Not sure what they mean by that. Monogatari, Japanese works of fiction, especially those written from the Heian to the Muromachi periods. They compare it to a mystery, paranormal, psychological light novel. Explain to me like I'm five here. What? Developed from the storytelling of women at court during the Han period, men wrote in Chinese. It was women who developed this form of Japanese prose. Some early monogatari, however, are believed to have been written by men under women's names. Huh, interesting. And they're like mystery, paranormal mystery stuff. Interesting. I'm just skimming over. Kind of curious what that means with everything else. Fading Reason, a Monogatari that is a little bit like a cousin. Fading Reason. Treachery and inhumanity. Fading Reason. Her life is like that of a story. Like a mystery. It's relative in a way. It's treacherous and inhumane that her life, that the life she lives is as like that of a mystery or like a story. Like a light novel, I suppose. Well, that one threw me for a loop. That one I'm not so sure about. But I'm going to wrap this part up and definitely clip it out. Probably put it on YouTube later as well. I'm curious what people will say. Nymophila fans, most definitely.